is just fantastic.
Captain's log, subdate 210615.9. I have commissioned someone to make me a 3D printed ISO cube so that I can have my very favorite inmate or pet on my desk with the sole purpose of being so that I can torture them because I'm a good judge. Welcome everyone to the Halls of Injustice. Today we have inmate number 078, Glyn Viney. Glyn Viney was a married man from the Isle of Wight and had worked at the Newport Library. While working at that same library, Glyn would use the computers to make contact with those he had taken a romantic interest in, obviously after his divorce. Isn't it handy that after being divorced, one has access to facilities that will best allow him to find love all over again? I wish him nothing but the best of luck, but as he's in the ISO cubes, the only love you'll get comes courtesy of a veiny Pringle tube or a veiny Smarties tube. We shall of course get to the reason why very soon. One day during 2019, Glyn Viney took interest in one of the people using the facilities of the library. So being young and hip 43-year-old that he is, he used the library database to track down the user. And then, being the young and hip 43-year-old man that he is, he went and installed Snapchat, and managed to, because he used the database to track them on Facebook, find their Snapchat, or Instagram, to then go to Snapchat. I can't be bothered to work out which one it was, via those rather irritating integrations. With this being a rip-roaring success and him finding his new love interest, he decided that even though he can pass for a 15-year-old, as you can tell from this mugshot, that he would need to, let's say, not draw attention to his IRL self. So like most people on the internet, he fabricated a new identity. It's really sad that people feel the need to do that. And yes, that is said with no level of irony. This new identity would be a third of his own age, almost. At the age of 15, yes, he's passable. He would also, because his name was a bit too obvious, possess a more inconspicuous name, Gary Barlow, not for obvious reasons to be confused with the lead singer of the boy band Take That, one of the most successful boy bands in British music history. There was a key reason though for the deception. And the reason was, is because the person he had taken an interest in was herself 15. So he wanted to be absolutely certain that the fellow 15-year-old that he had taken an interest in really appreciated him for who he was. So he added her on Snapchat and thus began a whirlwind, rather weird romance. Feel free now to replace the word romance with the word grooming, because that's what it actually is. With this deception in place, Gary Barlow, as we shall now call him from henceforth until we get to the arrest, started conversing with Jane Doe, as we will now call the victim, via Snapchat, and it didn't take Gary Barlow long to turn this into something quite sexual. Gary Barlow would ask for things as simple as nudes. And I say simple loosely. He would then escalate this again not long after onto things a little more sinister. For example, he would ask for Jane Doe to perform sexual acts on herself and then send the footage to him, because Gary Barlow would then use MobiZen on his phone. MobiZen is a screen record software app, and he'd record all of it. During these conversations, while a lot of it was itself sexual, Jane Doe would share her insecurities and vulnerabilities with Gary Barlow. And because of this, Gary Barlow was able to then best take advantage of her, because he'd use the same insecurities against her to manipulate her into doing whatever he wanted for his own gratification. And there is a stellar excuse for this later, don't worry, you're going to love it. One of Jane Doe's more notable struggles was the fact that she herself resided within foster care. So yes, Glyn, yeah, I'm going back to that now, was taking advantage of a highly vulnerable minor, tried to imagine my shock. Eventually, though, because of how pushy Gary Barlow was becoming, Jane Doe got very uncomfortable with what was being requested. So she approached her foster carer, and they then went to the police. And it didn't take long for them to then trace it back to him, because he, like everyone else, is a fecking genius. Which is good in this instance, because criminals are usually stupid, which means I can put them away a lot quicker than those that appear to be a bit smarter. It seems the collective IQ is somewhere below 50 at this point. And if you do yourself possess an IQ under 50 and are in any way offended by that, that sounds like a you problem. We're here to talk about crime after all, not you. So, in August of 2019, Glyn Viney, aka Gary Barlow, was arrested. He was charged with 3 counts of causing or inciting a child to engage in sexual activity, and 2 of attempting to incite a child to engage in sexual activity. When the police arrested him, they obtained his phone, and they found on it similar conversations with different profiles, one of whom appeared to be a victim of just 13 years old. Sadly, with all of those cases though, they were unable to trace the victims, so they couldn't realistically use it against him, only at best to point out there is a pattern of behavior. When presented with all the facts against him though, he admitted guilt. But he had an reason, and that was that he had a mental breakdown after the breakup of his marriage, which presiding judge recorder Anna Midgley said was indicative of his shame. Although he did concede he was going to prison and he did not see himself as a victim. David Richards, who was defending Glyn Viney, said that Glyn was someone who had a productive and decent life which he had thrown away, and that Glyn Viney had no intention of doing anything like it ever again, and he did not understand where it came from or why. He did also add that Glyn was overwhelmed by issues in his life, the pressures of work, the fact his mother was unwell, his inability to get satisfaction from relationships with people his own age, and that Glyn did not maintain the pretense throughout, and eventually owned up to being a married man. As Glyn Viney had admitted to 3 counts of causing or inciting a child to engage in sexual activity, and 2 of attempting to incite a child to engage in sexual activity, he was obviously found guilty, and with it came a sentence. The sentence reads as follows. Recorder Anna Midgley sentenced him to 3 years and 4 months in prison, along with being placed on the sex offenders register indefinitely and being subject to a sexual harm prevention order for 10 years. He also has to pay the victim a surcharge of £181. As far as the sentence goes, the sentence itself of 3 years, 4 months in prison, let's just pretend we can move it a decimal point to the right and make it 34 years in prison. I'm okay with that sentence. When it comes to sex offenders of any variety, my sentence is always going to be life. Get in your cell, you disgusting man. These sex offenders register indefinitely, I support, as I do the sexual harm prevention order for 10 years. Surcharges are a strange one, and I firmly believe he should just pay her compensation, like restitution, for the rest of her life. Because I'm a dick, we all know this, it's well established. Now, as we're done, I do want to know what you think. Please do let me know in the comments down below, especially the sentence. It is quite intriguing, there is a lot of effort he put into what he did, and he claimed it all to be a mental breakdown. Fascinating. Also, it would drive up my engagement. As a final thing, I shall be streaming on Twitch tonight. If I don't see you there, have a fantastic day, and thank you all very much for listening.